Good morning everyone. Today we are going to discuss about safety devices and meeting needs of patient. In safety devices, restraints, side rails and trapeze. There are three are there, main three, restraints, side rails and trapeze. Restraints are used to restrict the movements of the sick baby in the bed. The restraints should select the appropriate, safe and comfortable one. However, the use of restraint should be restricted to the minimum. The restraint may be provided manually with the help of some device. While during physical examination or any therapeutic procedures or diagnostic procedures, the child may need to be restrained for some conditions. In that conditions, to protect from injury, the child must needed restrained, okay? In that cases, we provide restraints to the babies or a person or a mentally disabled candidates. What is the definition? Restraint is defined as the intentional restriction of a person's voluntary movement or behavior, okay? Next one, restraints are, there may be physical, chemical and environmental measures used to physical behavioral activity of a person or a portion of his or her body. These restraints are physical, chemical, environmental measures and used to control the physical or behavioral activity of a person or a portion of his or her body. What is the purpose of restraints? To carry out the physical examination and to provide the safety to child, to protect the child from injury, and to complete the diagnostic and therapeutic procedures, to maintain the child in prescribed position. Okay, these are the purposes of restraints: to carry out the physical examination and to provide the safety to child, to protect the child from injury. What are the indications of restraints? Displaying behavior that is putting others at risk at harm and requiring treatment by a legal order. If any mentally disabled candidates are there, we must use these restraints for protection. If they are displaying behavior that is putting themselves at risk of harm, that's why we are using these restraints. Needing to be maintained in secure settings. And there are some principles are there for use of restraints. Should be selected to reduce client's movement only as much as necessary. Nurse should carefully explain type of restraint. What is the type of restraint and what is the reason of its use? We must explain to the client or neighbors. And after that, should not interfere with treatment. Bony prominence should be padded before applying it. Before you are applying that restraints, we must be covered with pad the bony prominence, because they may be feel discomfort to the patient. That's why we must cover that bony prominence with padded. And next one, always select safe and appropriate and comfortable restraints. And restraints should not be too tight or too loose. It should not interfere with the normal circulation, okay? And after that, always maintain comfort to the child and maintain body alignment. Should be changed when they become solid, soiled or damp, okay? Any damp or soiled or any dirt is there, we must be change that restraint immediately. And after that, do not give too much tight knot. Should be able to quickly release the device. And next, observe the restraint every 20 to 30 minutes to prevent any complications. To prevent any complications, we must observe the restraint every 20 to 30 minutes. And next one, change the side of child, because if any bedridden patients are there, there may be bed sores, pressure sores will be there. So, in order to getting that pressure sore, we must reduce that pressure sore. We need physical mobility will be there. Okay, will be needed. Physical mobility needed. So, side by side, we must change this side by side to the person. And next one, what are the types of restraints? There are physical, environmental, chemical restraints are there. What are the physical restraints? physical restraints are anything near or on the body which limit a client's movement. This may be attached to a person's body or create physical barriers. For example, table fixed to a chair or a bed rail, it cannot be opened by the client. Okay, physical restraints are anything near or on the body which limit a client's movement. For example, mummy device and elbow restraints, jacket restraints, glove hitch restraints. These are the some of the types of physical restraints. Anything nearer or on the body which limit a client's movement. And next one, environmental restraints. Environmental restraints are that change or modify a person's surrounding. Here, anything near on the body, physical restraints. Environmental restraints, surroundings, okay? Change or modify a person's surroundings to restrict or control a client's mobility. For example, secure unit of garden or seclusion. And next one, chemical restraints. What are the chemical restraints? Any form of psychoactive medication used not to treat illness but to intentionally inhibit a particular behavior or movement. That medication used to not treat illness but intentionally inhibit a particular behavior or movement. Okay, intentionally to decrease the behavior, any misbehavior or any incoordinary movements are there. We need to decrease that. We must use chemical restraints. It is a form of psychoactive medication. What are the types of physical restraints? Mummy restraints, elbow and knee restraints, extremity restraints, abdominal restraints, jacket restraints, mitten, crib net, safety belt, side rails and splints. Okay. We see one by one. In mummy restraint, mummy device involves securing a sheet or blanket. This is mummy restraint. It is a sheet or blanket around the child's body in such a way that his arms are held to his sides and his leg space movements are restricted. This is mummy restraint. What is the purpose of mummy restraint? For examination or any treatment of the head and neck, we must use these mummy restraints, okay? Treatment of the head and neck, we must use mummy restraints. Any diagnostic procedures are there, okay? Or any operative procedures are there, we must use these mummy restraints. Example, ENT examination or scalp veni puncture. Okay, this is the purpose of mummy restraints. For examination or treatment of the head and neck. For example, ENT, that means ear, nose and throat. What is the procedure of mummy restraint? The child is placed in an open blanket. First, we must place a child in an open blanket, which is adjusted in such a way that one edge is under the child's neck and another extends beyond its feet. The child's arms are placed by the sides. This is the procedure of mummy restraints. Okay, mummy device involves securing a sheet or blanket around the child's body in such a way that his arms are held to his side and his leg space movements are restricted. Okay, this is the mummy restraint. It is a short-term type of restraint used on infants and small children during examination and treatment of head, neck and face. It is used to immobilize the arms and legs of the child for a brief period of time. Okay, for example, ear examination or any gastric lavage, eye irrigation, scalp vein punctures. In that cases, we must use mummy restraints used on infants and small children. Okay, this is mummy restraints. And next one, elbow restraints. What is elbow restraints? This restraints is used to prevent the infant from flexing his elbow so that he is unable to remove the nasogastric tube or scalp vein. Okay, we observe these elbow restraints in NICUs, neonatal intensive care unit. In neonatal intensive care unit, if any babies have any complications during delivery, in that cases or any preterm babies and IUCR babies, we must keep that babies in neonatal intensive care unit. In that cases, we observe nasogastric tube because they are unable to swallow. So he is unable to swallowing. So that type, we must use elbow restraints. Okay. The restraint is used to prevent flexion of the elbow and to hold the elbow in an extended position so that the infant cannot reach the head and face. Knee joint also can be restrained, can be so to control the flexion of knee. Okay. This elbow restraint is used in case of face and head surgeries. This is elbow restraint. Okay. This is elbow restraint. And next one, extremity restraint. Okay. What are the purpose of elbow restraints? This may be useful in cases of operation on head, face, scalp, infusion to secure trans-anastomotic nasogastric tubes and to prevent crashing in case of skin odor. Okay. What is the procedure? Elbow is extended. First we have to extend the elbow and next padded. And next bandaged with a wooden spatula placed on the anterior or flexor aspect. This is elbow restraints. And next one, extremity restraint. What is meant by extremity restraint? It is used to immobilize one or more extremities. Extremities means legs and hands. One type of extremity restraint is clavage restraint. What is the extremity restraint? Clavage restraint. Clavage restraint is used to immobilize the arm or leg. It is prepared from a piece of gauze or soft cloth or crepe bandage. It is prepared from a piece of, you see here, piece of gauze or soft cloth or crepe bandage. Okay. To prevent tightening of the bandage, precautions must be taken. And the next one, this restraint should be used with paddling of wrist or ankle. Okay, this is extremity restraint to immobilize one or more extremities. And next one, abdominal restraint. This restraint helps to hold the infant in a supine position on the bed. For this restraint, use wide size wooden strips. Place the cotton pad appropriately to provide the proper comfort. Okay, to provide proper comfort, we must place a cotton pad. And next one, mitten or finger restraints. Mittens are used for infants to prevent self-injury by hands in case of burns, facial injury or operations, eczema of the face or body. Okay, mitten can be made wrapping the child's hands in gauze or with a little bag, putting over the baby's hand and tie it on at the wrist. Okay, we must tie the mitten to the child's hand at the wrist with a gauze or any pad. Okay, this is mitten or finger restraint. In case of burns, facial injury, operations, eczema of the face, we must use these finger or mitten restraints to prevent self-injury by hands. Okay. And after that, jacket restraints. Jacket restraint means, what is meant by jacket restraint? Jacket restraint is used to prevent the child from climbing out of the crib of a chair. Okay. Child can sit and sleep in supine position while wearing jacket. It can use on chair also. This restraint is used to avoid the child from climbing over the side rails, climbing out from chair, bed, cot, etc. We must use this jacket restraint. And after that, these are the restraints. These are the restraints. What are the restraints? Types of restraints. mummy restraint, elbow restraints, jacket restraints, claw hitch restraints and mitten or finger restraints. What is main purposes of the restraints? Children may need to be restrained for some diagnostic therapeutic procedures or during physical examination, and also in order to protect the child from injury. And after that, maintain the child's safety and protect him from injury. It also facilitates examination, minimizes the child's discomfort. This is the safety devices. In safety devices, restraints are subtopic. Okay, these are the purposes of restraints. And next one, what are the main objectives for restraints? To avoid clients from falling, to prevent interruption of therapy, and to prevent confused or combative client from removing any life supportive equipments, to reduce the risk of injury to others. Main, these are the objectives of restraints. This is very important for 5 marks. Okay, in safety devices is important. Under that, restraints are very, very important question in final exam. Types of restraints, purposes and general principles of restraints. Now we are going to discuss about hazards of restraints. What are the hazards of restraints? These restraints may use it to psychologically unfit patients or any children, infants. While diagnostic procedures, we must use these restraints. While using these restraints, there may be tissue damage under restraints due to constant friction. Due to constant friction, maybe tissue damage will be there, or poor blood circulation will be there, because if we tie not very tightly or too tightly, there may be poor blood circulation will be there and damage to other parts of body, example dislocation. And after that, if any prolonged and bedridden patients are there, development of pressure sores and ischemia or nerve damage and foot drop, wrist drop, asphyxia means difficulty in breathing, aspiration pneumonia, development of other complications, that is inability to climb, to escape from injury or accidents, and psychic injury. Psychic injury means the client may feel that he is punished, and it may cause death. In sometimes death also occur. And after that, side rails and splints. Side rails and splints. What is meant by side rails? Side rails are safety measures that comes under category of environmental control. These side rails are safety measures that comes under category of environmental control. These are attached to both sides of the bed. These side rails are attached to the both sides of the bed, and to prevent the client from getting out or falling out of the bed. Side rails must be kept raised on beds of all clients who have altered level of consciousness. Who have altered level of consciousness, that patients must have side rails, must be kept side rails, to prevent the client from getting out of bed, and to prevent the client from falling out of bed, to observe the client, to prevent the type of injury, we must provide side rails. We kept side rails to the clients who have altered level of consciousness. Okay, these are the main objectives: to prevent the client from getting out of bed, and to prevent the client from falling out of bed, to observe the client, and to prevent the type of injury. These are all the objectives. And next one, uses of side rails. What are the uses of side rails? Client with altered level of consciousness, we must use side rails, and the elderly clients. Okay, in elderly clients, and debilitated clients, altered level of consciousness in elderly clients, debilitated clients, these are the uses. And after that, objective is to prevent the client from getting out of bed and to prevent the client from falling out of bed, to observe the client, to prevent the type of injury. What are the benefits? Aiding in turning and repositioning within the bed, and handhold for getting into or out of bed, and provide a comfort and security to the patient, and reducing the risk of patients falling out of bed when being transported. And after that, access to bed controls and personal care items. These are all the benefits of side rails. And next one, if a person has suffocating or injury or may death when patients or part of their body are caught between rails or between the bed rails and mattresses. Okay. More serious injuries from falls when patients climb over rails. Any cuts, scrapes and skin bruising are there, we must use these side rails, may risk the any cuts and scrapes, and feeling isolated, unnecessarily restricted, preventing patients who are able to get out of bed from performing routine activities such as going to the bathroom or retrieving something from a closet. These are all the risk of bed rails. And next one, trepiche. A trepiche, a horizontal bar hanging on chains, is often attached to a large overhead frame which itself attached to the bed. The trepiece which itself attached to the bed. It is used by the client to pull up to sitting position or to lift the shoulders and hip of the bed. These are the side rails, okay? This is the side rails and this is trepiece. Use an overhead trepiece to move in bed, okay? The trepiece is used by the client to pull up to a sitting position or to lift the shoulders and hips of the bed. It is a bar hanging on chains. It main used for bed exercises. Okay, this is the trepiece. And what is the nurse role? Nursing role. Monitor a patient in restraint every 15 to 20 minutes. We have to observe signs of injury, circulation, range of motion, comfort, readiness for discontinuation of restraint. These are all the main principles to observe the client: signs of injury, circulation, comfort and readiness. After that, documentation in every 2 hours. We must observe the client every 15 to 20 minutes. And after that, documentation in every 2 hours. Release the patient, turn and position. Hydration, nutrition needs, elimination needs, comfort and repositioning needs. And after that, release the patient and turn position. And after turn position, restraint will be released. And after that, water or any nutritional needs we must provide. As a nurse, we have to observe the client. What he or she needs, we must provide it as per needs. Elimination needs, that means urinary elimination or any needs will be there, we must provide and keep aside. Comfort and repositioning needs. And after that, assess the client's behavior and the need for restraint and applies as a last resort. Get written order and obtain consent as per hospital policy. Must communicate with the client and family members, complies with institutional policies and guidelines for restraint. Explain the client the reason for the restraint and cooperation. Arrange adequate assistance from competent staff before carrying out the restraint procedure. Before we carrying out the restraint procedure, once we must intimate to the physician. apply the least restrictive, reasonable and appropriate devices. Based on client comfort only, we must keep the restraints and we must provide the restraints. Arrange the client under restraints in a place where he is close and regular observation, and after that particular attention to his or her safety, comfort, safety, dignity, privacy and physical and mental conditions. Based on physical and mental conditions only, we must provide these types of restraints. And next one, attend the client's biological and psychological needs during restraints at regular intervals. Reviews the restraints regularly or according to institutional policies. Nurse must maintain his or her competence in the appropriate and effective use of restraint through continuous education. We must minimize the use of restraints. Okay, till now we have discussed about restraints, types of restraints, what are the types of restraints, mummy restraint, elbow restraint, claw hitch restraint and jacket restraint. These are all the types of restraints and what are the purposes of restraints, and what are the instructions, objectives and hazards we are read. And after that, side rails and splints. And after that, trapeze. Trapeze is a horizontal bar hanging on chains, is often attached to a large overhead frame which itself attached to the bed. Okay, and after that, nurse's role. We must provide restraints to a particular patients only. We must observe the client every 15 minutes, 15 to 20 minutes. What they need, we have to provide that. Okay, this is the safety devices: restraints, side rails and trapeze. Once go through this topic. Thank you.